Hello, my name is Michael de Miranda, and I hope you've enjoyed the rhythm you have just heard. That's a way of playing samba that's done by the famous school of Unidos de Villa Isabel. This is a very great school. Actually, they won the competition this year of 2013 in Rio. They were the winners of this year's competition. So they must be doing something very good. Well, what is special about this school? Let's start with the patterns for the caixa. They have two different kind of patterns. One is for the caixa and the other is for the tarol. And the tarol is also a caixa, but a little bit thinner. The pattern for the caixa is like this. You can read it. It's not too difficult. It's like this. One, two, three, four, and... So you have four 16th notes, and the first one and the last one are the loud ones. But you have to be careful, because if you just play it the way it is notated, I have to say it different. You have to be careful and watch the timing. The timing is important. Don't play it straight. There's a samba feel in it. So like this. And of course they play it faster, but still play this timing, like. This is one pattern, just straight playing this pattern without rolls or other things. Well, for the tarol, you have to hold it like this. They play it encima, like they say it. So up here. You have to stick different in your left hand. You have to hold it like this, sorry. And the pattern starts like this. First, the right hand in the middle. Then the left hand. Then two strokes with the right hand. The first is a rim shot here. And then to the middle again. So. And after this, how do you say it? It works like this. One, two, three, four. Like this. Oh, I miss it a lot because I'm not used to playing like this, but you get the meaning. It's like this. One, two, three, four. After this stroke here at the rim shot, there are two coming in the middle. Then the left hand is coming. So you have one, two, three, four. After the two, the left hand is coming. And after this, the last stroke is again a rim shot. And then to the middle again. And this is the first stroke again. So the complete pattern is like this. One, two, three, four. And this one is the beginning. So let me play it very slow. One, two, three, four, and. Sometimes they play two strokes in the beginning with the left hand instead of like this, they play two strokes. Like this, yes? That's the tarol. And those two patterns for the caixa, they mix very, very well. Okay, let's go to the surdos. For the surdos, it's good to know that Villa Isabel is one of the few schools that tunes the first surdo higher than the second surdo. Like you probably know, Most of the time, the first pseudo is the lowest of all the pseudos. But Villa Isabel is tuning the first pseudo higher than the second. So the second pseudo, who is playing on the one, sounds low. So the second pseudo is just on the one. So you have one, two, one, two. And this is the low pseudo. The first pseudo is just playing normal on the two, but is tuned higher. Keep this in mind. Yes, so the first pseudo is like this. One, two, one, two, one. And the third pseudo is making the variations and is playing like this. The first beat, they play the hand. The second beat, they have two strokes like this. One, two, one, two, one. And the second time on the two, they have the three strokes. So the pattern that the third pseudo is playing is like this. One, two, one, two, and. And of course, the third pseudo is making the variations, yes? Okay, the other instruments like repenique and tambourine, and the other instruments are just like the other schools. So the repenique sounds like this. The tambourine is played like this. The shukayu is played like this. Okay, now you have a nice idea of the patterns of Villa Isabel. Let's put all the patterns together and let's see how it sounds. Well, like you have seen, Villa Isabel has two different kind of caixa patterns. I put a link in the description down here where you can see other caixa rhythms too. I've made already a tutorial about caixa, the caixa patterns in samba. Perhaps you like to see it. You can see it in the description. I hope you have enjoyed this lesson and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.